عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا. اللهم لا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا. اللهم اجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، وانصرنا على من عادانا، ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا. وبعد، today is Monday and today's date is the 17th of Rabi al-Thani for the year 1435 of the Hijra, of the migration of our great beloved Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, which coincides with the 17th of February for the year 2014. Monday is designated to study the seerah, the life, the wonderful, magnificent life of our great beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. And after we studied the history of the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, shifted to study the personality, the character, the morals, the devotion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. And we mentioned earlier many times, time and time again, that the purpose of learning about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the person, the Prophet, the Messenger, and Nabi Rasul, for two reasons. First, the more you know about his wonderful character, akhlaq, adab, the more you will love him. And the more you want to be like him, which is the second point. And that is the purpose of sending Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Because la ilaha illallah, it means very simple. Doesn't need a whole book of explanation. There is no true God worthy of worship except Allah. لا معبود بحق إلا الله وإلا المعبودات بباطل كثيرة. There is no true God worthy of worship except Allah. False gods, false worship of false gods are everywhere. Starting with people who worship their own lust, to those who worship idols and the trees and mountains and constitution and man-made law or a territory or a nationality or a race or ethnicity, you name it. The worshippers are, mashallah, Rabbil Alameen, a dime a dozen, everywhere. And وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Very simple. We worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the message that Muhammad brought from Allah. So, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ. Indeed, you have in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a pattern, an example, a role model. And wallahi ya akhwa, there is no human whatsoever. After the commission of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is a role model, a role model, except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Role model, that means you model yourself after him. You look up to him to be like him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the more you know him, the more you love him, the more you love him, the more you want to be like him, the more you want to worship Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala like him. And today, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, I want to share with you two verses and two ahadith. And these two verses is to illustrate to us and remind us about the tenderness, the softness, and the mercy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How merciful sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how compassionate sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were to his ummah, to his followers. To his followers. Amazing. Two verses and two hadith. Okay, the two verses to illustrate how merciful Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was, especially to all the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and specifically to his ummah, his followers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among them truly. The first verse in Surah At-Tawbah, Surah number 9. In Surah At-Tawbah, Surah number 9, in verse 128, maybe 27, let me check. 128. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is characterizing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Listen carefully. Allah says, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ. يعني ما هو من المريخ, بشر من البشر. عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. الرأفة وانتهى الشفقة. والرحيم هو الذي يرحم ويوصل رحمته. لما نقرأ قول الله سبحانه وتعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, الرحمن هو الذي رحمته ورحمته وسعت كل شيء, واسع الرحمة لا حدود لها. والرحيم كما كان يقول شيخنا ابن عثيمين رحمة الله عليه, الرحيم من على وزن فعيل, أي الذي يوصل رحمته. ممكن واحد يكون رحيم لكن ما يستطيع يفعل شيء, رحمن رحيم ما يستطيع يفعل شيء, لكن الله سبحانه وتعالى رحمن ويوصل رحمته سبحانه وتعالى لمن أراد من خلقه وخاصة العباد المؤمنين. بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. اسمع يا عبد الله, there has certainly come to you a messenger from among yourselves, human like you, Arab like you, grieves him, grieves to him, saddens him, saddens him is what you suffer. Allahu Akbar. What you suffer. Pay attention to this verse and you will know why we are going to study this hadith, inshallah Rabbil Alameen. He is concerned over you. He is concerned over you sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, and to the believers is kind. Kind. And the word compassionate is much more closer to the word ra'uf. Kind and merciful, and to the believers is kind and merciful. He's so compassionate. His heart cares so much about you, and he is what? Merciful. very merciful. Yeah. This is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. One more time the translation. There has certainly come to you a messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from among yourselves, sadden him is what you suffer. Yeah? He is concerned over you. He wants you to be guided. And to the believers, is kind, compassionate, and what? And merciful. And merciful. Yeah? That means, yeah? He always thinks about you. He wants the best for you in this life and the hereafter, especially in the hereafter. The other verse in Surah Al-Anbiya, Surah number 21. In Surah number 21, Al-Anbiya, the prophets. And that's very important to remember the name of the Surah. Al-Anbiya, the prophets. Verse 107, 107. Allah Al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ قل إنما يوحى إلي أنما إلهكم إله واحد فهل أنتم مسلمون الله أكبر. And we have not sent you, O Muhammad, except as a mercy to the worlds. Yeah? To everything that Allah created and Muhammad صلى الله عليه وعليه وسلم can reach. Directly or indirectly. Is he a mercy to the kuffar? Yes. Is he a mercy to the animals? Yes. Is he a mercy to the environment? Yes, for sure. How do we know? From his statements and his behavior, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And most important, his feelings. His sympathy. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he said what? Yeah. Say it is only revealed to me that your God is but one God, so will you be Muslims in submission to him. Now look how much Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to care. How concerned Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was about his ummah. Yeah? About his ummah. The hadith reads in Sahih Muslim, in the book of al-Iman, the book of faith, Babu Dua in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam li ummatihi wa bukaihi shafaqatan alayhim. Yeah? Babu Dua in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam li ummatihi wa shafaqatihi wa bukaihi wa shafaqatihi alayhim. The supplication of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for his ummah and his weeping out of compassion for them. Out of compassion for them. The hadith reads, An Abdullah ibn Amr, An Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, رضي الله عنهما أن النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تلا قول الله عز وجل في سورة إبراهيم سورة 14 verse 36 he recited قد تلا قول الله سبحانه وتعالى تلا قول الله عز وجل في إبراهيم ربي إنهن أضللن كثيرا من الناس فمن تبعني فإنه مني ومن عصاني فإنك غفور رحيم. قبلها الآية إيش تقول؟ وإذ قال إبراهيم رب اجعل هذا البلد آمنا واجنبني وبني أن نعبد الأصنام. And mention يا محمد When Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam said, alayhim salatu wassalam, said, my lord, make this city, the city of Mecca, secure and keep me and my children away from worshipping the idols. Allahu Akbar. Yeah? الآن يجينا واحد يقول يا أخي أنت خايف علي؟ يا أخي أنت خايف علي؟ نعم والله خايف عليك. هذه القلوب بين أصبعين من أصابع إيش؟ الرحمن. يا؟ قل يا أخي أنت خايف علي؟ يا؟ He said, yeah, nowadays, someone who talked to him said, well, you are afraid for me? Yes. Because the hearts are between two fingers of الرحمن سبحانه وتعالى. Changes them as he wish. Look, Sayyidina Ibrahim saying what? He said, and mention Muhammad when Ibrahim said, my Lord, make this city, city of Mecca, secure and keep me and my sons away from worshipping the idols. If Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was afraid of worshipping the idols for himself, and for his children, and what about me and you? That's the reason in every single rak'ah we say what? Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Then he said, the verse that Rasulullah quoted, my Lord, indeed, Rabbi innahunna adlalna kathiran min al-nas, faman tabi'ani fa innahu minni wa man asani fa innaka ghafurun rahim. My Lord, indeed, they have led astray many among the people. So whoever follows me, then he is of me. And whoever disobeys me, look. Sayyidina Ibrahim not say what, destroy him. He said, and whoever disobeys me, indeed you are yet forgiving and merciful. So وقال عيسى عليه السلام إن تعذبهم فإنهم عبادك وإن تغفر لهم فإنك أنت العزيز الرحيم. In reference to Surah المائدة verse 118 where Allah الكريم سبحانه وتعالى said about عيسى إن تعذبهم if you should punish them, indeed they are your slaves. You own them. And no one is going to question you. Yeah? They are your slaves. But if you forgive them, indeed it is you who is the exalted in might, the wise. فرفع يديه صلى الله عليه وسلم عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنه said what when the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم recited the saying of Allah سبحانه وتعالى in regard to سيدنا إبراهيم my lord indeed they have led astray among the many among the people so whoever follows me then he is of me and whoever disobeys me indeed you are yet forgiving and merciful. And when he recited the saying of Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala concerning Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, if you should punish them, indeed they are your slaves. But if you forgive them, indeed it is you who is exalted in might, the wise. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam raised his hands. Wa qala Allahumma ummati ummati wa baka. اللهم أمتي أمتي وبكى صلى الله عليه وسلم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم raised his hands and he said what يا الله my أمه يا الله my أمه and he cried صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم فقال الله عز وجل يا جبريل. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heard and saw the crying and the prayers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah said, oh Jibreel, اذهب الى محمد وربك اعلم. Yeah? Go to Muhammad, although your Lord, Allah is still talking, although your Lord knows exactly why he is doing that. وربك أعلم, and Allah knows best exactly why he is doing that. فسأله ما يبكيك. Go ya Jibreel to Muhammad. Although I know very well why he is crying, but I want you to go and ask him, what made you cry? Why you are crying? فأتاه جبريل عليه السلام فسأله. And عليه السلام from the text of the hadith. Yeah? جبريل عليه السلام came to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and asked him, why you are crying? Why you are quote unquote so emotional? فأخبره رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بما قال. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم told him about what Allah said, وهو أعلم. And while Allah knows best. So رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم told him what? Although Allah knows best, but I am crying because I recited this verse and that verse. I.e., look how Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was so compassionate, so merciful, so caring about those who disobeyed him. And look at Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, how caring, compassionate about those who disobeyed him. What about me? فقال الله يا جبريل اذهب إلى محمد فقل إنا سنرضيك في أمتك ولن نسوءك. So when جبريل عليه السلام went back to Allah and told him, while Allah is very well knowing about why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was doing that. When Jibreel reported this to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Jibreel, go back to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and say, we promise you, Allah promises you, that we are going to please you concerning your ummah, and will never displease you concerning your ummah. If we cannot be totally like Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have to do our best to be as close as possible to Sayyidina Muhammad. As close to Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Which reminds me, Imam ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullah alayhi كتب رسالة صغيرة الذي تسموها العرب أكتوبة, يعني على وزن أكذوبة. وابن تيمية من أسبق السابقين اللي سماها ورقة, في الإنجليز الآن هي wrote a paper. هذا استخدمها ابن تيمية من زمن طويل. فقال رحمة أهل السنة بأهل البدعة. عنوانها رحمة أهل السنة بأهل البدعة. الله أكبر. The title of the small paper he wrote, the title is what? The mercy of the people of Sunnah for the people of bid'ah. When we tell them this is bid'ah and this is wrong and this is haram and you cannot do that, it's not out of revenge, it's not out of hate, it's not out of scolding them, but because we do not want them to end in Jahannam. And he mentioned that you have to be as tender and as compassionate as possible when you what extend them, extend to them what the nasiha. Yeah, the nasiha. Yeah, that's why the ulama said what. قالوا الأمر باثنتين أمر الدعوة باثنتين قال الدعاء والدعوة الدعاء والدعوة الدعاء والدعوة ها when you advise the people it's based on two things first you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first to make you sincere and second for them what to accept the advice second the دعوة the reminder, the invitation, the advice, the nasiha. دعاء ودعوة دعاء ودعوة أما الدعاء لأنه لا يهدي إلا من الله سبحانه وتعالى nobody guides but Allah سبحانه وتعالى yeah? so you care so much for their guidance so we have to be compassionate like رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم huh? How much does it take for each and every Muslim? Yeah, if it's not every day, every month, to say what? Allahumma aghfir al-mu'minin wal-mu'minat. Allahumma ahd al-dhalin. Allahumma ashfi al-marda. Allahumma aqda hajat al-muhtajin. Allahumma ansur al-mujahideen. Allahumma aslih lil-muslimin dinahum. Allahumma aslih lil-muslimin dunyahum. Allahumma aslih lil-muslimin akhiratahum. Kam ta'khud, ikhwan? Ma ta'khud kathir. Ha? Ma ta'khud, wallahi ma ta'khud. How long does it take to say, Ya Allah, forgive all the believing women and the believing woman, the believing men and the believing woman. Ya Allah, forgive every sinner. Ya Allah, heal every sick. Ya Allah, provide for every poor. Ya Allah, amend for the Muslims their deen. Ya Allah, amend for the Muslims their dunya. Ya Allah, amend for the Muslims their akhirah. It does not take much. And do not underestimate your dua. Especially if it's coming from your heart sincerely for the sake of Allah and especially when you are tender that you feel it that you are so close to Allah raise your hand say Ya Allah اهدي أمة محمد يا الله اغفر لأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم you do not never underestimate yourself yeah? You feel it sometimes that you are that close to Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala. So open your heart to Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second hadith that I would like to share with you, it is in the book of, I'm reading in Sahih Muslim, under the title, Babu Ikhtiba'i Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam da'wata al-shafa'a li-ummatihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. دعوة الشفاعة لأمتي ذات رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم subtitle ذات رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saved his special دعاء his special supplication is this over him? Okay saved his special دعاء yeah what is the special دعاء Allah granted each prophet each messenger a special دعاء they said what you have one time One da'wah for your ummah. If you pray to it, if you pray to me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer as you prayed for. Yeah? And this is for all the prophets and the messengers of Allah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saved this one time du'a. So he can intercede, which is to make dua. The intercession is to make dua, not more, not less. Before Allah, for his ummah, in the day of judgment. And the hadith are many, but let me quote this hadith that is amazing. Okay? The hadith, I'm reading still from Sahih Muslim. Yeah? The hadith reads, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لكل نبي دعوة مستجابة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم or the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said what? Every Prophet has one دعوة, one supplication that it will be answered. Because people, they assume that every time the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer the dua as he asked for. This doesn't happen. But Allah granted each and every Prophet one dua. Said, okay, this is the dua. Yes, Allah answered many, many of their dua, but this is your one chance. If you use it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer it exactly as you prayed for. فَتَعَجَّلَ كُلُّ نَبِيٍّ دَعْوَتَهُ. And he said, every prophet has used his da'wah. Has used it while he was alive. Everyone, no exemption. وإني اختبأت دعوتي شفاعة لأمتي يوم القيامة. And I, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, in regard to me, I saved my da'wah, my one supplication, so I can use it as an intercession, as a shafa'a for my ummah, my nation, my followers, al-Muslimun, on the day of resurrection. فَهِيَ نَائِلَةٌ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. Look at the modesty. مَنْ مَاتَ مِنْ أُمَّتِي لَا يُشْرِكُ بِاللَّهِ شَيْئًا. الله أكبر. فَهِيَ نَائِلَةٌ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ مَنْ مَاتَ مِنْ أُمَّتِي لَا يُشْرِكُ بِاللَّهِ شَيْئًا. So, it will reach every single person of my ummah who died without associating anything with Allah. A sinner? Yes. Major sinners? Yes. As long as they die on a tawheed. If they die on a shirk, Jahannam will be a masir. And even the Muslims who end in Jahannam, said Muslims end in Jahannam, not mushrikun, eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept the shafa'ah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and bring them out from where? Jahannam. From Jahannam to Al-Jannah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. So he was sallallahu alayhi wa sallam worrisome about us in this life while he was alive, and he was thinking about us way ahead when we meet who? Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. So please, let all of us be like Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we should start not very far. Pray for your spouse, Muslim or non-Muslim. Pray for your parents, living or dead, Muslims or non-Muslims. Pray for your children, pray for your brothers, pray for your sisters. Never say, well, my brother is 40 years old. Now I'm going to pray for him for the hidayah. Who knows? Who knows? Who knows when the hidayah is going to come? And, yahi, be selfish. You pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a person, Allah to give him the hidayah. Now, instead of the only worshiping Allah, now he will worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will give the reward of what? One or two? Two people. Every time he says Allahu Akbar and he offers Salat al-Dhuhr, Allah will give him the reward. He said, well, for Abdul Khaliq also a reward because he prayed to me for you. It's not difficult, ya akhwa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروه. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. The class is over. If you have any correction, any questions, or any concerns, or any corrections, we'll entertain them in the remaining times, inshallah.